morning students, welcome to my YouTube channel Bhagavat. I'm Vishwanandananda. Today we are going to discuss about the cell. The structural and functional unit of life. First of all, we have to know what we mean by a cell. A cell is a unit structure of any living organisms. It may be your unicellular organisms or multicellular organisms. Every living organisms consisting of cells. Like, suppose, have you seen a constructing house? Perhaps all are known. A mason is constructed a wall by the help of bricks. Bricks. The bricks are systematic in position and form a wall. Like this. Suppose these are bricks and the bricks are cemented and form a wall. Like this, every organism has a single unit, that is the structural unit. It is called cell. The word cell is first coined by Robert Hooke in 1665. Robert Hooke, an English scientist, Robert Hooke, he discovered cell. How he discovered cell? He first made his own compound microscope and a button cork. With a button cork, he observed that the cork has many empty spaces. The cork has many empty spaces without any compact mass. So Robert Hooke coined this empty space as cell. So this cell is derived from a Greek word, kaitos. It is a Greek word, kaitos, that means vessel or container. Later we have to know this cell also comes from a Latin word, cellula. Cellula. Cellula means small room or container. So first, Robert Hooke discovered cell. The cell which was discovered by Robert Hooke, it was dead cell. It was dead because it is lack of protoplasm. It is lack of protoplasm, the living material. We know the living material is protoplasm, and the Robert Hooke the compartment without any protoplasm. So we can say that Robert Hooke discovered dead cell. Later on, another scientist named Anton von Leeuwenhoek, the scientist Anton von Leeuwenhoek, by his own microscope, he observed the living cell. The living cell. Living cell. That means the protoplasm is present inside the cell. And the scientist is Anton von Leeuwenhoek. Later, in 1831, Robert Brown, another scientist, Robert Brown discovered a spherical mass present inside the cell. It is located in the central region, in the central part of the cell, and that spherical object is called nucleus. So we can say Robert Brown discovered nucleus. Then after 1839, in the year 1839, two scientists named Sheldon and Swan, the two scientists Sheldon and Swan, Sheldon and Swan Swan discovered cell theory or cell biology. Cell theory discovered by Sheldon and Swan. And another scientist named Rudolf Virchow. He states that every cell arises from the pre-existing cells. Virchow. The scientist was Rudolf Virchow. He states that every single cell is arises from the pre-existing cell. Every cell is arising from a pre-existing cell.